We developed a new system that's easier to describe when I make a comparison with light microscopes. At light microscopes, you are used to take your hands and operate quite complex things in a very easy way. For example, you can make a cut over a surface of a sample and at the same time talk with your neighbor and hear music. When you try to do something like this in the electron microscope, it gets to a nightmare. You can look only with one eye through a small pinhole of 2 or 3 millimeter image size. You look into the dark, you don't know where the samples are. You have no information of height and where are tools. And your hand-eye coordination that ease your operations in air is broken by the vacuum chamber. We solved that problem. And that's all of the message. When you think about that, you can imagine where we are today. So we have a wristwatch. We have small gears, make artificial babies, eye surgery, all with our hands under light microscopes. And in the electron microscope, all these things are up to now not possible. And we enabled this with some technology. And I can show you examples about this technology now in a demonstrator here at our stand. On this exhibition, we have prepared now a demonstrator that shows the situation in electron microscope. Instead of the electron source, we use a video microscope. And instead of the ZEM sample stage, we use our own sample stage. And now we have a task where we have to find a certain point on a sample, and we don't know where it is. There we start an automatic macro. We like to land an electrical probe, but before we do this, our nanofinger, a special instrument, comes to the field of operation and detects the surface height and topography to find a nice landing area that is flat for an electrical probe. So that's now first the nanofinger detection. It's done now. The nanofinger lands its tip by itself, and now the electrical probe comes in and goes to the predefined point found by the nanofinger, and now an IV curve can be done. So I cannot speak as fast as this process is, and that's the way how easy we can find unknown surface heights and guide other tools. I talked about the nanocutting done by hand on the micron scale or millimeter scale very easily under the light microscope. How can we do this in the electron microscope? We use a cutting module, and in this module that starts with the look and feel of our software, you have an empty screen and you select a macro out of the list, and this macro is called Nanofinger finds sample. So at first, here's my sample. The nanofinger comes automatically into the field of view, detects the height of the sample, and moves back again out of the field of view. Nothing has changed except that we now know where is the sample. And then we can take any other tool that we like, for example, an electrical probe, or in this case, a cutter to cut lines. An assistant window opens, asking you to make 2 crosses to cut one line or 3 crosses to cut an array of lines. So we selected 3 crosses with the mouse. And I say then, start here, okay. And the automatic process starts to cut a line, an array of lines. We have a movement resolution of 0.5 nanometer over strokes of 20 times 20 millimeter. And this cutting range is now in a broadness of about 200 microns. And when it's finished, it has a height of about 40 microns, so it's in the mean scale area. And it's about 800 times faster than with an FIB. So you can see this as a poor man's FIB, or you can see this as a booster for chipping away material on a bigger scale.